Hello friends, today we discuss about Pascal's law. Pascal's law states that the intensity of pressure at a point in a fluid at rest is same in all direction. Means Pascal's law is applied for the fluid which is at rest. Means when the fluid is at rest and if we apply pressure at a point, then the intensity of pressure at a point in a fluid at rest is same in all direction. So consider three direction XYZ. So according to Pascal's law, pressure intensity is same in all direction. So we derive Px is equal to Py is equal to Pz. Consider one wedge shaped element in a fluid mass at rest and width of the element is unity. Here as shown in figure, angle ABC is equal to theta. Angle ABC is equal to theta. And dimension is given AC length, for example, DX, for AB, that is DY, and for BC, that is DS. Then apply pressure at each face. For example, pressure acting on the face AB, that is PX. This is x direction, so pressure acting on the face AB, that is Px. Similarly, pressure acting on the face AC is equal to Py, that is y direction. So pressure acting on the face AC, that is Py, and that is z direction. So pressure acting on the face BC, that is Pz. Then find forces acting on the element. If we apply pressure, what is the meaning of pressure? Pressure is equal to force per unit area. So if we want to find pressure force, then pressure force is equal to P into area. So next step, we find pressure force on each face. For example, pressure force on the face AB, that is pressure into area. So pressure acting on the face AB, that is Px. So Px, that is pressure, and area, area means length multiply width. So here AB length is a dy and width of the element we assume unity, so 1. So here area is dy into 1. So Px into dy into 1. Pressure force acting on the face AB, that is given by pressure acting on at x direction multiplied dy into 1. Similarly, we find pressure force acting on the face AC. So here pressure acting on the face AC, that is Py. So pressure force is equal to pressure, that is Py, multiply area, area that is given length multiply width. So here length is dx and width is unity, so dx into 1. Similarly, pressure force acting on the face BC, here pressure is acting Pz. So pressure force is equal to pressure acting at z direction, that is Pz, multiply area, here length is ds and width of the element is unity, so ds into 1. So first consider one wedge shape element. So consider an arbitrary fluid element of wedge shape in a fluid mass at rest, and we consider width of the element is unity, and here angle ABC is equal to theta. Then find pressure acting on the face AB. Then apply pressure acting on the face, means pressure acting on the face AB, that is Px. Pressure acting on the face AC, that is Py, and pressure acting on the face BC, that is Pz. Then find force acting on the element, means pressure is equal to force divided by area. So pressure force is equal to pressure into area. So forces on the face AB is equal to pressure in x direction multiply area of face AB. So pressure in x direction, that is Px, and area of face AB, AB length is dy, and width of the element is unity. So pressure force on face AB, that is Px into dy into 1. Similarly, force on face AC, that is Py into dx multiply 1. Then force on face BC, that is Pz into ds into 1. So in this way we find force on each face. Then find weight of the element. For example, element weight, that is W, and this weight is always acts at its center of gravity. So then next find weight of the element. General formula for weight, that is mg. So mass into gravitational acceleration. So what is the meaning of density? Density is equal to mass per unit volume. So what is the mass? Mass means density multiply volume. So in place of mass, we can write density multiply volume multiply gravitational acceleration, that is weight. So what is the meaning of volume? Volume means area multiply length, or you can say area multiply width. So volume is equal to area multiply width. And what is the area for this element? Here we consider wedge shape element, means triangular shape. So triangle area is 1/2 base into height. So 1/2 base, that is AC, and height, that is AB. So here we can write, in place of area, we write 1/2 AB into AC, and we consider width as a unity. So in place of width, that is 1. So here we write 1/2 AB into AC. So in place of volume, we can write density as it is. In place of volume, we can write AB multiply AC divided by 2 into 1. So 1/2 AB into AC into 1, and G as it is. What is the length of AB? Dimension for AB, that is dy, and dimension for AC, that is dx. So in place of AB and AC, we can write rho 1 by 2. In place of AB, we write dy, and in place of AC, we write dx multiply g. So this is the weight of the element. Again, I repeat, weight of the element always at its center of gravity. And weight, general formula, that is mg. So what is the meaning of density? Density is equal to mass per unit volume. So mass is equal to density multiply volume. So density multiply volume multiply gravitational acceleration. Then find volume. Volume means, general formula, area into width. Here we consider wedge shape element, that is triangular shape. So we can write 1/2 AB into AC, and we consider width as a unity. So volume equation, 1 by 2 AB into AC multiply 1. So in place of volume, we can write 1/2 AB into AC into 1, rho as it is, and G. So here weight of the element, that is rho multiply 1/2 dy into dx into G. Next step, from the figure, we find cos theta and sin theta. So from the figure, cos theta is equal to AB divided by BC. And sin theta is equal to AC divided by BC. So from the figure, we can write cos theta is equal to AB by BC. So AB is equal to BC cos theta. AB dimension, length is dy, and BC, that is ds. So dy is equal to ds cos theta. And similarly, we find sin theta. So sin theta is equal to AC by BC. So AC is equal to BC sin theta. So AC length, that is dx, and BC dimension, that is ds. So dx is equal to ds sin theta. So next step, find cos theta and sin theta. So cos theta is equal to AB by BC. So we get dy is equal to ds cos theta, and sin theta is equal to AC by BC. So we get dx is equal to ds sin theta. Then next step is, this element is at rest, means algebraic sum of horizontal forces is equal to 0, and algebraic sum of vertical forces, that is 0. Here Pz acting inclined. So resolve in horizontal component and vertical component. For example, that is, this angle is theta. So resolve horizontal component and vertical component. So this is angle opposite side. So that's why sine. So we write Pz sine theta. and this is angle adjacent side, so write cos theta, so pz cos theta. Then this element is at rest, means in equilibrium condition. That's why algebraic sum of horizontal forces is equal to zero. That's meaning summation of left side force is equal to summation of right side force. So here right side pressure force, that is px dy into 1, and left side pressure force, that is pz cos theta multiply area. Area is ds into 1. So this force acting right direction, so we consider plus, and this is opposite direction, so we write minus. So write, resolve the forces in x direction, px into dy into 1 minus pz cos theta ds into 1 is equal to 0. So dy into 1 dy, so px into dy minus, that is z ds cos theta. Here value is ds cos theta, so we find ds cos theta is equal to dy. So in place of ds cos theta we can write dy. So px dy, in place of ds cos theta we write dy. So dy dy cancel out, so we get px is equal to pz. Again I repeat, resolve the forces horizontal direction. Here element is in equilibrium condition, that's why algebraic summation of horizontal forces is zero. Here horizontal forces px into dy into 1, and that's act at right direction, and opposite direction, that is pz cos theta, that is pressure, and pressure force means pressure into area. So pz cos theta ds into 1. So solve this and we get px is equal to pz. Similarly, resolve the forces in vertical direction. So vertical direction, pressure force acting vertical direction, that is py dx into 1. Weight of the element in opposite direction, so write minus. So weight of the element we get rho multiply 1 by 2 dy into dx into g. And similarly, one downward force, that is pressure force, is pz sin theta. Pressure force means pressure into area, so pz sin theta, that is pressure multiply area, that means ds into 1. So pz sin theta into ds into 1, that's also act downward direction, that's why minus. So next step is resolve the forces in y direction. That's why our equation is py dx into 1 goes upward direction minus pz sin theta ds into 1 minus 1 half dx into dy into rho g is equal to 0. Here element is very small, so the weight of the element is negligible, so consider this value is a 0. So we get py dx into 1 minus pz sin theta ds into 1 is equal to 0. So we get py into dx is equal to pz ds sin theta. In place of ds sin theta we can write dx. In place of ds sin theta we get dx. So py dx, and in place of ds sin theta we write dx. So pz dx cancel out, so we get py is equal to pz. That is equation number 2. So from equation number 1 and 2 we can write px is equal to py is equal to pz, because in equation number 1 we get px is equal to pz, and in equation number 2 we get py is equal to pz. That's why px is equal to py is equal to pz. So we can say that any element which is at rest, and if we apply pressure, then intensity of pressure at a point in a fluid at rest is same in all direction. Thank you.